Hey guys, Megan here, and I am here to tell you that I broke my book buying ban, and not because I consciously made the choice, okay, today I'm going to treat myself and I am going to break my book buying ban so that, you know, like before I was doing this book buying ban where I'm like, okay, I'm going to finish all the books that I own and then I'll like give myself a wonderful treat once I finished and I'll buy all these wonderful books and it'll be great. I never make it to that point. I have 10 books left, well now I have more, 10 books left that I had not read that I own. And I always get down to about 10 and then I go, I'm almost there, it'll be okay if I go into a bookshop, I won't buy anything, it'll be fine. No, it never is. I always buy something or many things. So yeah, this morning I was downtown and I was shopping for birthday presents and I did find birthday presents. So yay. But I also found many birthday presents for myself. So I thought I will just haul them right now. Now I've been thinking about Booktober a lot, still a few months away, but Booktober was what really got me into YouTube because like, I got into Booktube, like, just as Booktober was starting up in, like, not starting up for the first time, but, like, starting up again in 2017, I guess it was, and I watched all these Booktober videos, and I was like, I need to read more Brontes. I have only read Jane Eyre. Since then, I've listened to the abridged version audiobook of Wuthering Heights, and I would like to actually read the full version. Now, I do own Wuthering Heights, so I'm like, okay, maybe for Booktober this year, I will read Wuthering Heights. I was also wanting to read Tenant of Wildfell Hall, so I was like, oh, it'll be okay if I go in this bookstore. I'll just see if they have Tenant of Wildfell Hall. It'll be fine. Well, they do have it. They did have it. Now I have it. And they had some other Bronte books. So I will show you what I got. So first of all, as I said, I got The Tenant of Wildfell Hall by Anne Bronte. That sticker will be coming off. It'll look much better. Yeah, just in the Penguin Classics edition. I have like a few other classics in this edition. And I'm excited to read some Anne Bronte because I haven't read any of her, obviously, and it's about time that I get to it. So, sorry, I'm just so hot. It's so hot outside. Thank goodness I have air conditioning. So, Tenant of Wildfell Hall. Next one, The Professor by Charlotte Bronte. I've heard this is like her least amazing work because this is her first. It got rejected the first time around. And Anne Bronte and Emily Bronte, their works didn't get rejected. They all went in, they put in their first manuscripts. I think it was Wuthering Heights, Agnes Grey, and The Professor, and The Professor got rejected and the other two got published. So, but I still bought it because I'm still sure that it's good because it is Charlotte Bronte. I also got Shirley by Charlotte Bronte, which I'm really looking forward to read. I've heard really good things about it. Now, there was a really beautiful copy of Villette there that I wanted to get by Charlotte Bronte, but it was like in a regular bookstore, I would have paid the same amount. So I did not get it, which is, I'm sad about it, but I'm also like, good job, you showed some self-control. I also got two other books, non-Bronte books. Now these ones, okay, as you can see behind me, I have a lot of L.M. Montgomery, probably one of my four favorite authors for sure. So here I've got some short story collections. L.M. Montgomery wrote like 500 short stories. So these are some of her short story collections that were put together in like the late 80s, early 90s. So you've got Among the Shadows, so like spooky stories. You've got At the Altar, stories that are about marriage or ended marriage. And Along the Shore, which I really enjoyed, which is all about the sea, mainly the Atlantic because PEI is in the Atlantic Ocean. So today I found some more and I knew that there were more collections of her short stories and I've read more short stories than are just in these three. I've read like hundreds of her short stories. But I did find two more collections, Akin to Anne, Tales of Other Orphans. This was the first collection that was put together by Rhea Wilmshurst. Rhea Wilmshurst put all these together. So this was the first one that she put together, so I'm really happy about that. And also Across the Miles, Tales of Correspondence. I'm really looking forward to this one too. I think it should be interesting. So yeah, I I got books. I'm now up to owning 15 books that I have not read, but that is okay. I will not be hard on myself. Grace. All the grace in the world. So, but this does mean that I need to keep reading. So I'm going to say goodbye for now and go read my current book. This is my new tripod and my new light. So thank you, Daddy, for finding this for me. I did pay for it, but my dad found it for me. So I am gonna be playing with the lighting and the location and all that. Oh, it's so nice. I don't have anything like in the background, like behind, that I don't want. It's just like you can see my books. Finally, it's close enough. You can see my books. Hey everyone, Megan here, and I broke again. Again, I bought more books. Now, I have no judgment on those who do buy books. Just for me personally, I try not to buy very many books, and I bought 3 more, which means that the count is now up to 18 unread books that I own. So I'm going to haul those next 3 books for you. So I've got 1 more Bronte and 1 more Ella Montgomery here to share with you, and then another book, which I'm very excited about. I'm excited about all these books, though, let's be honest. Okay, so the first book, let's get it here. The first book I bought a couple days after I bought my other Bronte books was Agnes Grey by Anne Bronte. So now I own Tenant of Wildfell Hall and Agnes Grey. So I know Agnes Grey was written first, but I think when I do start my Anne Bronte obsession, that I will start with Tenant of Wildfell Hall because I have heard that it is the better novel. So I think I want to start with that one, let that get me hooked, and then read Agnes Grey. If you think I should read Agnes Grey first, let me know. Maybe there's something I don't know about, like, obviously they're not a series, they're not related, but maybe it's better to read Tenant of Wildfell Hall second. So the other book I bought was another collection of short stories, although it was originally a novel. So I bought The Road to Yesterday by Ella Montgomery. Now, this book was published in 1974, so almost, well, over 30 years after Ella Montgomery died, and it is, there's some about the Blythe family in here, spoilers for Anne of Green Gables, some about Anne Shirley Blythe and Gilbert Blythe and their children in here, as well as some other short stories. Now this, the way it's published now is not how Ella Montgomery wanted it to be. This other book is the exact manuscript that she wrote. This is the, you can see my new light. This is the Blythes are quoted. Now, I said this in another video at some point, that this was the last book that Ella Montgomery wrote. She wrote this, she wrote the manuscript, she was extremely depressed, she was in a terrible place, it was the height of World War II, and she was just heartbroken. Everything in her life was falling apart. The one good thing in her life was her younger son, Stuart, and he was about to enlist. So she finished writing this manuscript, which is very like anti-war, kind of recounts everything to an extreme that she wrote in Rilla of Ingleside. So she dropped off the manuscript to the publisher or had somebody else drop it off, different stories on that. And the next day she was found dead of an overdose. The overdose could have been accidental, but we do know that she was sad enough to die from her journals. So the publishers looked at this anti-war in the middle of World War II and they're like, we can't publish this. Like, people aren't gonna sign up. People aren't gonna join up. We can't publish this. So over 30 years later, the publishers went, hey, there's this manuscript that we still haven't published. We should publish it, but we can't publish it. We can't publish it like this. So they kind of cut out a lot of the anti-war stuff. They kind of kept it more happy and stuff. Then this was published. Then in 2009, the original manuscript was published under the Blythes are quoted. So I bought this one. So I've got them both now. Now the last book I bought, I'm very excited about this because Kate Howe, I love Kate Howe. I have loved Kate Howe for years, long before I was a BookTuber. I feel a little starstruck even saying this, but Kate Howe asked me to do a buddy read with her. Now I've never done a buddy read with another BookTuber besides my sister, Sarah Hanet, and my cousin, Naomi, from Naomi's Bookshelf. So we are going to do a buddy read in August for Classicsathon that Lucy the Reader is hosting. We will be reading the book Christie by Catherine Marshall. This is a terrible cover. Please know that I'm sure that this is going to be really good, even though it has such a stupid, cheesy cover. Yeah, it's based on a true story based on Catherine Marshall's mother. So it's about a young 19-year-old girl who leaves the city and goes to a backwoods, like, little village in Tennessee, I think, to become a school teacher at a mission where, you know, these kids are starving and, you know, their parents are usually, like, alcoholics and aren't able to care for their children. So there was a TV show made in the 90s. One season it lasted. It ended on a cliffhanger and then it was canceled. And I grew up watching that show. So I'm really excited to finally read the book that it's based on. So yeah, those are all the books that I now own. I'm really excited to read them all. I still need to finish Betsy and the Great World, although by the time this video goes up, I probably, hopefully, will have finished it, and hopefully we'll have a review video on it. So that is what I will be doing for the rest of the weekend. So, yeah, if you have read any of these books, let me know. Let me know if you think I should start with a particular one, although I'll probably be saving the Brontes for Booktober. I will not be able to read all those Brontes during Booktober, though, so maybe I should start sooner. So, yeah, may you all be filled with peace, hope, love, and joy. So take care, everyone.